Welcome to another example of finding the partial fraction decomposition of a given rational expression. Notice the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, so we can go ahead and proceed by first factoring the denominator completely. Well, x to the third plus 4x squared has a common factor of x squared, so we'd have the quantity x squared plus 8 divided by x squared times the quantity x plus 4. Notice in this form we have three linear factors, though the linear factor of x is repeated, which will affect how we set up our fractions on the right side. Again, because we have two linear factors of x, our first fraction will have a denominator of one factor of x, the second fraction will have a denominator of x squared. This is how we handle if we have a repeated linear factor, plus the third linear factor of x plus 4. Again, because we have linear factors in the denominator, that means our numerators will be constants, but we don't know those values right now, so we're going to use the variables a, b, and c. So our goal here is to find the values of a, b, and c so that we know the three fractions that if we sum them, we obtain the original rational expression. So for the next step, we're going to clear the fractions from this equation by multiplying both sides of the equation by the LCD, which would be x squared times the quantity x plus 4. So notice on the left side, everything simplifies nicely, x squared over x squared, x plus 4 over x plus 4. So we just have x squared plus 8. On the right side, for the first product, only one factor of x simplifies out. That would give us ax times the quantity x plus 4. For the next product, x squared over x squared simplifies out, leaving us with b times the quantity x plus 4. For the third product, we have x plus 4 over x plus 4, that simplifies to cx squared. This is called our basic equation, which we'll use to find the values of a, b, and c. And there are two methods to do this. One is to select the values of x that would make the factors involving x equal to 0, which we've done on the previous examples. The other method is to use a method called equating the coefficients, which we'll do in this example. So we're going to multiply out the right side and then combine like terms by factoring. So we'll have x squared plus 8 equals, here we'd have ax squared plus 4ax plus bx plus 4b plus cx squared. Now we want to group the x squared terms, the x terms and the constants, so we'd have x squared plus 8 equals, we'd have ax squared plus cx squared. Notice how we have the x squared terms next to each other, plus 4ax plus bx plus 4b. And now we'll factor x squared out of these two terms and x out of these two terms. I'm also going to write the left side as x squared plus 0x, which is still 0, plus 8. And you'll see why in just a moment. So we'll factor out x squared. That would give us a plus c times x squared plus, again, factoring out x would give us 4a plus b times x plus 4b. And now we'll equate the coefficients, meaning the x squared terms on the left and right must have the same coefficient. The x terms must have the same coefficients on the left and right, and the constants on the left and right must be the same. Which means, since the coefficient of x squared is equal to 1, 1 must be equal to a plus c, 0 must be equal to 4a plus b, and 8 must be equal to 4b. Let's go and start with the most basic equation. We know that 8 must equal 4b, or 4b must equal 8. Next, we know that 4a plus b must equal 0. And we also know that a plus c must equal 1. Well, now we'll use this system of equations to find the values of a, b, and c, which will give us our partial fraction decomposition. So looking at this first equation, if 4b equals 8, we would divide both sides by 4. We know b equals 2. Well, if b equals 2, we can use a second equation to find the value of a. We would have 4a plus 2 equals 0. Subtract 2 on both sides. We have 4a equals negative 2 divided by 4. So we have a equals negative 1/2. And then now that we know a is equal to negative 1/2, we can find c using the third equation. We would have negative 1/2 plus c equals 1. Add 1/2 to both sides, we'd have c equals 1/2, or c equals 3/2. So now that we have the values of a, b, and c, we can go ahead and substitute these values into our fractions here for our partial fraction decomposition. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So the original rational expression, x squared plus 8 divided by x to the third plus 4x squared. Of course, we could leave the denominator in factored form, but since a is equal to negative 1/2, this is the same as a times 1 over x, we would have negative 1 over 2x. Notice how the 2 ends up in the denominator with our factor of x, plus b divided by x squared, b is 2, so 2 divided by x squared, plus c divided by x plus 4, but c is 3/2. This is the same as c times 1 over x plus 4, so we'd have 3 divided by 2 times the quantity x plus 4. Now normally you won't see the first term negative, so let's go ahead and change the order of this. Let's go ahead and write this as 2 divided by x squared minus 1 over 2x plus 3 divided by 2 times the quantity x plus 4. Obviously both of these forms are correct, but I think the second form is probably more common. I hope you found this explanation helpful.